The teaching of Vedantu was amazing. One aspect where Vedantu teaching differed from a normal offline coaching was the attention teachers gave to our doubts. No matter how many times we asked a doubt, the teachers would patiently clear the doubt every single time. And they made learning a very fantastic experience for us.
Hello everyone, what's up? Welcome to the class. If I'm audible, if I'm visible, please write yo in the chat box. Let me see if you guys are able to see and hear me. Welcome to yet another class of the mole concept, which is going to be our final class of the mole concept chapter, in fact. So, aaj apan kya karenge? We will continue with the equivalent concept that we were discussing in the last class. So, the last class was aired on the Tuesday at 5 p.m. Now, today we are going to continue with the discussion that we did in that class. I hope you remember all of that. We'll do a quick summary. And then we will move on to the concept of normality, which is something that a lot of people fear. But once you understand it over here in today's class, it's going to be super chill. And after that, we'll try to solve a bunch of questions. All right? Theek hai? Spara Gupta, all right, bro, please watch all the classes from the beginning. I'm sure you'll be able to understand. We have not classes and started this class yet, so I hope you are understanding what we've done till now. Anyway, Khushi Agarwal, these videos are good for JEE Advanced as well. The only thing is that to prepare for JEE Advanced, you will have to do a lot of practice on your own as well. All right, so this is the last class of the chapter of the mole concept. All right, so people, can you remind me what we did in the previous class? We had tried to understand what is the valency factor. Yes, or valency factor se pata lag jayega that how many equivalents we have. Okay, this valency factor tells us how many equivalents we have. So in the previous class, we've done a detailed discussion on this. If you missed that, please go back and watch that class. So for H2SO4, since this guy has two hydrogens that it can provide, two acidic hydrogens, yes, the valency factor over here will be equal to 2. Fine. Let's take another example. Let us take an example of Na2CO3. This is a nice salt. What is the total amount of positive charge on it? 2 times plus 1. That is 2 positive charges. And what's the total negative charge on it? CO3 is 2 negative. So 2 negative charges. So what is the valency factor for Na2CO3? 2. It'll react in ratios of 2 whenever it reacts with anything else. Very good job, people. NaCl ke liye KK Mehta, the valency factor will be 1. Okay. And what does the valency factor signify? This signifies that 1 mole of Na2CO3 is essentially 2 equivalents of the reactant. Alright, similarly, 1 mole of H2SO4 implies 2 equivalents of the reactant. Yeah, this is the condition that we understood in the previous class. Now, theek hai, to yahan pe main fatafat se likh dunga how to decide the valency factors. This is something, again, throwback time to the previous class. Arre yaar, ye bada ajeeb sa hai iska. Alright, so acid ke liye, how do we define the valency factor? We count the number of H positives. Yeah, for base, we count the number of OH negatives. Brilliant. For the ions, we simply look at its charge. Yes, and for the salt, we look at its net positive or net negative charge. Yes. So, all of the valency factors are defined by the charges of all of these things. Alright, or ye jo hai, oxidizing agent, reducing agent, valency factor of that will be discussed in the upcoming chapter. Awesome. Chalo, itna revision ho gaya. Great, defining everything by charge, ye wo. Equivalent weights of common acids and bases are given over here. If you want to take a screenshot, take 5 seconds to do that. Spara, I would suggest you the book N Avasthi. That is a brilliant book for physical chemistry. Practice kar lo, bahut mast hai. Sanju, we'll understand that today. Yo Manu, yes Shivansh, it is also known as N factor. Chalo, ye sabne likh liya hoga. To dosto, ab aate hain is pe. This is one of the most entertaining parts about this particular concept. Okay, isme bahut maza aata hai. Pehle dekhte hain structure ko. Let's look at this structure. एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ इक्विवेलेंट वेट्स ऑफ एसिड्स ऑफ फॉस्फोरस. ठीक है, तो पहले इसको देखते हैं, H3PO4. कैन यू सी इट हैज थ्री एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन्स? एक, दो और तीन. यस, ये नोट करना, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. प्लीज नोट दिस डाउन, दिस इज सुपर इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, मेक श्योर यू हैव अ नोट ऑफ दिस इन योर नोटबुक्स. ऑल राइट, सो फॉस्फोरस का एसिड है. ओके, H3PO4, दी स्ट्रक्चर इज गिवन ओवर हियर. कैन यू सी दीज थ्री एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन? ये वाला जो हाइड्रोजन है, ये वाला जो हाइड्रोजन है, एंड दिस हाइड्रोजन, ऑल ऑफ दीज थ्री हाइड्रोजन आर एसिडिक इन नेचर. व्हाई? बिकॉज डू यू रिमेंबर द OH बॉन्ड इज पोलर. Remember this OH bond is polar. The electronegativity of hydrogen is approximately 2.1 and the electronegativity of oxygen is approximately 3.5. So there's a lot of electronegativity difference. This is a polar bond. As soon as you throw it in water, it has the tendency to break apart. All right, theek hai? तो जैसे ही अपन H3PO4 लेंगे ना, इसके पास थ्री एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन है. सो पीपल, फॉर द फर्स्ट केस, वॉट विल बी द वेलेंसी फैक्टर? द वेलेंसी फैक्टर फॉर दिस केस विल बी थ्री. Pretty damn obvious. Valency factor has to be 3. Yeah. So the equivalent weight is 98 upon 3. That is molecular weight divided by the valency factor. Very nice. Awesome. Now let us look at this case. H3PO3 ki baat karte hain. Okay. H3PO3. Can you count the number of acidic hydrogens in this case? के मेहता को कोई बता सकता है व्हाट्स द नेम ऑफ H3PO3? बोलो बोलो, ये तो नाइन्थ क्लास का डाउटर है. कोई ना कोई बताएगा चैट बॉक्स में. हाँ, सही सही सही. प्रीतम, अनमोल, अमर, जिनेंद्र, हरप्रीत, अमर, एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट मैन. दिस हाइड्रोजन ओवर हियर इज नॉट एसिडिक. या This hydrogen over here is not acidic. Why is it not acidic? Because that is a phosphorus to hydrogen bond. Hydrogen's electronegativity is approximately 2.1. Phosphorus ki electronegativity is approximately 2.19-ish. Something like that. So this is not a lot of electronegativity difference. This bond is not polar, hence not acidic. The only acidic hydrogens that we need to count are this one and this one. Yeah, because they are a part of the polar bond. So the hydrogens attached to the oxygen are the acidic hydrogens. Hence, the valency factor for this case is equal to 2. Theek hai? Nice. So, equivalent weight will be molecular weight by 2. That will be 41 in this case. Theek hai? I'll try to see. Slide aage jaati hai ki nahi? Haan. Chalo. Badhiya. Alright, and now let's look at the third case. Now it is obvious. This one is not acidic. This one is not acidic. Only this is acidic. Z is equal to 1 in this case. Only one acidic hydrogen. H3PO2. Okay, so ye dekh lo. Equivalent weight over there will be just 66. So please make sure you keep a note of this in your notes. I will give you 10 seconds to take a screenshot if you want. 10, 9. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Srikantan, Srikantan has a very nice question. Sir, if we have questions that can be solved by many ways, which method should we use? Srikantan, see, that is where practice comes into picture. The more you practice questions till your examination, the more number of ways you would have tried to solve a certain type of question, yes? Now, when you're in the examination, you will choose the method that is best suited for that question at that particular point of time. Okay? Maybe a method gives you an approximate idea. If the options are far apart from each other, then you would use that method because it will give you a fast result. If the options are very accurate, then you will do the full derivation. So, again, the more you practice questions, the better you will have the judgment of it. Manu, yo. Theek hai? Kritika, we'll see more and more examples of the valency factor using some questions as well. So, dheere dheere sab clear ho jayega. Okay. Soumen, yes, I will cover titration in the redox chapter. Theek hai? Chalo, badhiya. Ye ho gaya explanation of sabne note kar liya hoga. Chalo, ab chalte hain agle page pe. Let's do this question now. Okay. This question is very interesting. 12 grams of an element combines with 32 grams of oxygen. Okay, now we are coming into the place where your equivalent weights can be defined for anything, not just acids and bases. So over here the question says 12 grams of an element combines with 32 grams of oxygen. That's what's given. What is the equivalent weight of the element? Theek hai, chalo solve karte hain isko. All right. Manu, yeah, that will come spontaneously. Chalo chalo karo isko. Achha question hai. KK Mehta, see, the new pattern is just a new pattern of marking scheme, so we cannot say anything about the difficulty. My prediction is that it will be the same level. Okay, that's just my personal prediction. It could be harder, it could be easier. We'll get to know only on the day of the examination. My logic is that a lot of people were complaining to NTA last time around that the examination was harder than expected. So I'm assuming that they've cut down the number of questions so that you have more time to solve the same level of questions. That's just my estimation. We will get to know only in the examination what happens. Neon, agle chapter mein kara dunga dost. In the next 2 weeks, I will teach you the volume strength as well. Theek hai? Haha, RS, my team will update everything in the playlist. Chalo. So, people, let us give me an example of any compound of oxygen. Koi oxygen ka koi compound bolo. Generally, kya compound banta hai oxygen ka? Koi, any compound, you tell me. First, let's take water. Chalo, water sabse simple hai. Okay. Nice, everyone's talking about water. Alright, let's take some oxide, let's say MgO. Theek hai? Chalo, inhi do examples se baat karte hain. In MgO, alright, I'll take a black pen. In MgO, do you realize that this is Mg, 2 positive, and oxygen is 2 negative? Yeah? So, for oxygen, most of the times, okay, 90% of the times, except for the cases when it makes a superoxide or a peroxide, those are different cases, redox mein discuss karenge. But 99% of the times, oxygen always has a 2 negative character on it. Ya to uska charge 2 hota hai, ya oxidation state 2 hoti hai. For example, in H2O, if I draw something like this, yeah, I will give oxygen a 2 negative oxidation number, and for hydrogens there will be plus 1 oxidation number because oxygen has more electronegativity, hence it will keep these bonded electrons towards itself. Fine. So we have realized that for oxygen, okay, just for oxygen, oxygen ke liye valency factor is equal to 2. Awesome. CO2 mein bhi, haan Sanju, same. Yeah. So, Pritam, de do tum. Superoxide deke kaam kharab kar do. Nahin, abhi wo nahin karenge. KO2 hota hai, but we'll talk about those in redox chapter. So, yeah, K2O is still fine. Great. So, oxygen mein, Z is equal to 2. Valency factor is 2. So, chalo, isko hata deta hun, jo baaki sab kuch likha hai yahan pe. Now, for oxygen, if Z is equal to 2, what is the equivalent weight of oxygen? Is equal to molecular weight divided by 2. This is equal to 16 upon 2. This is equal to 8. So, what we've understood over here, that the equivalent weight of oxygen is 8. Okay? 8 grams of oxygen is equal to 1 equivalent. Ye apne ko chamak gaya. Alright, now over here you have 32 grams of oxygen. Yes, so ye likh lete hain, isko hata dete hain. 8 grams of oxygen is equal to 1 equivalent. Now let me take a red pen. Chalo ji. Yahan kya diya hai? 12 grams of some element combines with 32 grams of oxygen. To 8 gram ke saath kitna combine karega? Kar dun. 12 by 4 gram of element combines with 32 by 4 grams of oxygen. This is what? 8. So 12 by 4 kitna aa gaya? 3 grams. Why could we write this? Because one equivalent of something always reacts with one equivalent of something else to give you one equivalent of the product and one equivalent of another product, etc. etc. Okay? Theek hai ji? Ho gaya? Alright. So, over here, you have 3 grams is the equivalent weight of the element, as you are saying, yes, 4 equivalents are reacting.
ओके ठीक है.
आतिफ चमकी बात, डिड यू गेट द आइडिया. वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वेट which reacts with one equivalent of oxygen, because that will be one equivalent of the element. One equivalent of oxygen is 8 grams. So, 8 banane ke liye 4 se divide kiya dost. Okay. Manu, I think it was Desmos. Vaibhav, jaldi start karne ki koshish kar rahe hain dost. Later in October, most likely. Chalo, theek hai, ye ho gaya. Alright. KK Mehta, we'll discuss about that in organic. अभी तक नहीं देखा तो epic GOC देख लो, you'll understand. Cool. So, ये कर लिया अपन ने. Let me just breeze through the solution quickly. Yeah, fine. 3 grams per equivalent, great. Let's do this question now, quickly. Similar question, now that you know what's the equivalent weight of oxygen, this question will be very easy. Let me read it out, okay? It says 9.44 gram of a metal oxide is formed by a combination of 5 grams of the metal. ओके कैलकुलेट द इक्विवेलेंट वेट ऑफ द मेटल. फटाफट से करते हैं, आप साथ साथ में करो मेरे. 9.44 ग्राम इज इक्वल टू मेटल ऑक्साइड. व्हाट डज दिस मीन? मेटल प्लस ऑक्सीजन, यस. सो आउट ऑफ इट इट्स गिवन दैट 5 ग्राम्स इज अ मेटल. ओके तो ये है 5 ग्राम. तो हाउ मच इज द ऑक्सीजन? ऑक्सीजन कितना बचा? 9.44 माइनस 5, दिस इज 4.44 ग्राम. इफ आई डू एनी अदर रॉन्ग कैलकुलेशन देन प्लीज लेट मी नो. नियॉन फॉर चार्ज्ड आयन्स, द चार्ज इज द वैलेंसी फैक्टर बिकॉज दैट्स द रेशियो इन विच इट रिएक्ट्स. Okay, in redox reactions, the reactions are a little more complicated. So we look at valency factors for redox substances in that chapter. For simple salts and ions, yes, your statement is correct. ठीक है, ये आ गया. Oxygen 4.44 grams है, metal is 5 grams. तो अब क्या करना है? Equivalent weight of the metal निकालना है. हो जाएगा. 5 grams reacts with 4.44 grams. Yeah, so 5 by 4.44 into 8 grams of metal will react with 8 grams oxygen. What I have done is I have just multiplied by 8 and divided by 4.44 on both sides. ठीक है, तो ये कितना आ गया? This is equal to 1 equivalent of oxygen. So this will be equal to 1 equivalent for the metal. हो गया खत्म. कितना आ जाएगा आंसर भाई? Approximately 9 grams है ना. चलो बढ़िया. शैलेंद्र, गुड न्यूज, ऑर्गेनिक पहले चालू हो चुकी है. वी ऑलरेडी हैव क्लासेस ऑफ जनरल ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री ऑन आर सिस्टम. आई विल गिव यू द लिंक्स ऑफ इट. जस्ट यूट्यूब एपिक जीओसी, यू विल सी दैट. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, रिएक्शन मैकेनिज्म्स इज बीइंग स्टार्टेड बाय सौरभ सर वेरी सून, सो डोंट वरी, इट्स गुड. कोई बात नहीं मनु, इट्स फाइन. ठीक है, तो ये हो गया. लेट मी रिमूव दी कैलकुलेशंस दैट आई हैव डन. सॉल्यूशन कर लिया. हाँ ठीक है, 4.44, या सिंपल. सो 9 ग्राम्स अप्रोक्सीमेटली. वाह, आवर कैलकुलेशन वाज वेरी गुड. चलो दोस्तों, एक और क्वेश्चन. टेक दिस एज अ होमवर्क, प्लीज टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ इट. ये घर पे ट्राई करना. ओके, घर पे ट्राई करना इसको. ओके शैलेंद्र, जीओसी है, बाकी चैप्टर शुरू होने वाला है. ओके, सो गुड फॉर यू, यू विल गेट बोथ वेरी सून. ऑल राइट, आई विल गिव यू 10 सेकंड्स, टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. ऑल राइट, सो ट्राई करना इसको घर पे. बहुत अच्छा क्वेश्चन है. जिसका भी आंसर आ जाए, लीव इट इन द कमेंट सेक्शन ऑफ दिस वीडियो. ओके, आफ्टर द वीडियो जब कर लोगे, लीव इट इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. या इट्स द सेम टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन, जस्ट अ लिटिल कॉम्प्लिकेटेड इन द सेंस दैट इट आस्क्स यू द वेट ऑफ इट्स ऑक्साइड ग्रेटर देन द वेट ऑफ द मेटल. इट आस्क यू अबाउट अ रेशो, सो यू हैव टू यूज द लॉजिक दैट नंबर ऑफ इक्विवेलेंट्स ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट्स एंड प्रोडक्ट्स विल बी द सेम. ओके कूल. Ansh, yes, you can definitely do that if you practice a lot of questions from relevant sources, man. Chalo, dosto. Ab aate hain normality pe. Sounds weird, doesn't it? Chalo, let's do a little bit of a throwback. First, let us think of what is molarity. Okay, molarity pe aate. What is molarity? Molarity is, let me take a different colored pen, moles of solute, okay, in 1 liter of solution, yes? Perfect. So if I give you, okay, if I give you 1 mole H2SO4 in 1 liter, okay, in 1 liter of solution, this is equal to 1 molar. Ye sabko chamakta hai. Everyone understands this. Amor, I am basically from Patiala, bro. Chalo. Now, let us try to go towards the other side of the page. And now what I'll do is, for this particular solution, let's try to write something like this, okay? Let us try to write equivalence of solute, okay, in 1 liter of the solution. 1 mole of H2SO4 is how many equivalents? Jaldi jaldi batao. 1 mole of H2SO4 is how many equivalents? Z factor is equal to 2 because it can give you 2 H positives. Yes. So number of equivalents is 2 times the number of moles given. Hai na? For every H2SO4, you are getting double the amount of hydrogen. Z factor is 2. So yahan pe main likh sakta hun, this is 2 equivalent H2SO4 in 1 liter of solution. Okay, great. People, if I call this molarity, okay, if I call this molarity, can I call this equivalentarity? That's a very long word, isn't it? It's a tongue twister. Equivalentarity, you don't want to say that word. So let's use a better word. And this word is nothing but normality. As simple as that. Okay, the name sounds complicated. Normality is equivalence of solute in 1 liter of the solution. This is equal to a 2 normal solution. This is equal to 2 normal solution. And what we'll write on the top is pretty obvious. Okay. Normality is equal to the Z factor times molarity. Okay. Dekha, Z factor, N factor, valency factor times molarity will give you normality. As simple as that. Khatam. Congratulations, people. You have learnt the entire mole concept chapter. Party karte hain abhi. We'll try to look at a question as well. But yeah, this is what it is. Normality. Neon, jiska solution hai, uska valency factor dekhenge, dost. Manu Abhishek sir has gone for vacation with his family. So yeah, he needed a break. So he's on a 1 week break. He'll come back next week. Ansh, definitely, man. These are super awesome lectures for strengthening your concepts. But the practice part has to be done by you. Okay? Neon, dekho, yahan pe acid hai na? So, acid ke liye the valency factor comes by the number of hydrogens it has, H positives. Please, ek bar pichla class dekh lena, dost, agar zyada confusion hai to. Always Roxy is gonna come in the coming week. Agle hafte se normal physics classes. Chalo, normality is done. Now, people, again, let's compare it to molarity itself. Ek second. Again, let's compare it to molarity itself. Okay? Number of moles is equal to molarity into volume. Can I write this? Number of moles is equal to molarity into volume. Yeah, M into V. Theek hai? So, similarly for normality, what can I write? For normality, I can write equivalence are equal to normality into volume. Khatam. But Harshil, welcome to the class. Welcome to Vedantu. This is the last class of the mole concept chapter, so we are somewhere. If this looks far-fetched to you, please watch the earlier classes as well. Okay, Manu. Ansh is asking, what's the difference between Vedantu's free classes and paid classes? Dekho, paid classes mein kya hota hai? That there are more number of sessions, of course. Theek hai. Usme you have more teachers teaching you. You have academic mentors who will look at your doubt solving almost 24/7. You get lots of materials to solve. You are already enrolled in a part of the test series. Every Sunday you have to give a test, etc. So it's like an online coaching institute kind of a setting for the paid courses. Free courses mein you are getting the same content. Okay, it's just that the practice part has to be done more by you. That's the main difference. Okay, content wahi ka wahi hai bhaiya. Theek hai, chalo. Molarity into volume, normality into volume, number of equivalents, baat khatam. Ab dosto, let us say, okay, ye apan ne likh liya, okay, let us say A plus B gives you C plus D, and this reaction is unbalanced right now. Okay, this reaction is unbalanced right now. Okay, do you agree that the number of equivalents will be the same for everything? Okay, Ansh, definitely, yaar. Tum material karoge, to obviously it'll help. Yes, Kritika, it is. Do you agree that for this reaction, equivalence of all of these things will be the same? That is the equivalent concept, right? So what I can say is that equivalence of A have to be equal to equivalence of B. Equivalence kaise aayenge? NA into volume of A is equal to N of B into volume of B. If both of them are solutions, can I write this? Loji. You have very logically and obviously reached something that people fear a lot in schools. Schools mein aise bataya jata, pata nahi kya hai. N1 V1 equal to N2 V2. This is what it is. Number of equivalents has to be the same. In fact, this will be equal to the number of equivalents of C that you get. And this will also be equal to number of equivalents of D that you get. Okay, I'm just joking around. Some schools teach really well. But, if you fear this concept, it's as simple as that. It's not a law, it's obvious logic, given the kind of definition we've given to the equivalent concept. Jaisa define kiya concept, waisa hi logic hai, bas khatam. But definitely, yaar, tum ja sakte ho, dost. And if you enroll to the full course, it'll help you even better. But that's not compulsory, of course. Yashovardhan, that's also fine, man. The next chapter, Pankaj, is redox reactions. Toh chalo, ye sab ne likh liya hoga, I hope. Theek hai, chalo, ek question karte hai. Simple question, and from normality, super complicated questions, you know, will not be asked generally. Is tarah ke questions hote hain. More complicated reactions from equivalents come in redox. Wo apan agle chapter mein karenge. Pehle ye karte hain. A 0.25 gram sample of a solid acid was dissolved in water and exactly neutralized by 40 ml of 0.125 normal of a base. Calculate the equivalent weight of the acid. Simple. Simple. Sarvanan, I don't have an idea about NTSC Telangana. Yeah, so those pata nahi uske bare mein mujhe. Neon, I've explained it in the previous class as well. Ek bar jaake dekh lena, dost. Valency factor for a salt is equal to the net positive charge or the net negative charge, as simple as that. So, ya to positive charge dekh lo total, ya negative charge dekh lo total. ठीक है, NTSC के बारे में मेरे को ज़्यादा आइडिया नहीं है दोस्तों, JEE के बारे में जो पूछना पूछ सकते हो. प्रीतम, there are just two ways of thinking about the same thing, yeah, that's all. चलो, ये करते हैं. Alright, so what does it say? There is an acid and a base. ठीक है, let me write this. There is an acid and there is a base. Very nice. Now, people, do you agree that the equivalence of both of these will be the same? Futuristic DNA, see, if you want someone to hold you accountable, then yes. Baad mein baat karte hain paid courses ki, abhi is pe aate hain. ओके, इक्विवेलेंस ऑफ देम विल बी द सेम. सो इक्विवेलेंस ऑफ एसिड अभी पता नहीं है. ओके, इक्विवेलेंस ऑफ एसिड अभी पता नहीं है. इक्विवेलेंस ऑफ बेस आर इक्वल टू, इक्विवेलेंस आर इक्वल टू नॉर्मैलिटी इनटू वॉल्यूम. दिस इज इक्वल टू 0.125 नॉर्मल, ओके, इनटू 40 मिलीलीटर्स. ये देख रहे हो दोस्तों, दिस इज मिलीलीटर्स. सो नॉर्मैलिटी इनटू लीटर्स इज इक्विवेलेंस. ओके, सो दिस एंटायर थिंग इज इक्वल टू 4 इनटू 1.25 मिली इक्विवेलेंट्स. Instead of writing 10 to the power minus 3, instead of taking this in liters, I have simply taken the milli next to the equivalence. Milli equivalents hai ye, theek hai? So these are the equivalents of the base. These will also be the equivalents of the acid. Yes, these will also be the equivalents of the acid. So what do we have? The information that we have is 0.25 grams is equal to 4 into 1.25 milli equivalent. So how much will be 1 equivalent? You just have to calculate that. Okay, how much is 1 equivalent? You just have to calculate that. So milli equivalent ko equivalent kar doon main abhi. Theek hai. So I'll just multiply 1000 on both sides. Usse kya hoga? 250 gram is equal to 4 into 1.25 equivalent. Yes, just multiply 1000 both sides, milli chala gaya. Now what do we have? 250. This is a very simple calculation here. 250 upon 4 into 1.25 is equal to 1 equivalent. Kitna aa gaya ye? 50 gram. But yeah, thank you so much, man. Any difficulties in this? Yes, over then, we don't need to write a reaction, bro. You just need to realize that equivalents of the acid are equal to equivalents of the base. We don't know what the acid or the base is. We don't need to write the reaction. All right. So Yashovardhan, if you've missed the previous class, please go back and watch it. Janvi, not much, yaar. Usme itne complicated question nahi aate. I mean, this, they might ask you. Okay. So yeah. Okay. Futuristic DNA, we'll talk about the thing later. Okay. Reaction likhi nahi sakte yahan pe, acid base. I don't know what acid or what base it is. That is why we use the equivalent concept, because equivalents are the same in both of the cases. How do you get to the equivalents? Normality into volume. Khatam. Okay. Digvijay, Tuesday ko next chapter chalu kar rahe hain dost. Tuesday 5 PM. So let's look at the solution. Yeah, 50 grams per equivalent. Very nice. Cool. Next chapter is redox reactions, Gaurav. Okay. So people, pay attention. What we've done till now in these 7 classes of the mole concept is that we've understood this chapter in all detail possible. Okay. Every year, at least one question directly comes from this topic. And this topic is the basic of chemistry. The basic mathematics of chemistry, you can think about it like that. So in every other physical chemistry chapter, sometimes in the organic chemistry chapters and inorganic chapters, the application of these concepts is very useful. All right. So if you've attended all the classes, congratulations, high five. You have learned the mole concept. If you practice it, you'll be a master. If you haven't seen all the classes, please do watch them. They are in the videos section of the YouTube channel of Vedantu. Chalo. So ab thoda aage badhenge. This is just some data that I have for you, which you can note down. Okay. So people, you can take a screenshot of this. After I give you the data, I will solve questions with you. Okay. So questions baki hain abhi. We are yet to do some questions. Achhe advanced questions hain wo thode. So pehle ye likh lo, phir questions karte hain. Chalo. Screenshot le lo. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right. Now, for salt, someone was asking, ठीक है? Salt का पूछ रहे थे भाई कैसे करेंगे, ठीक है? Salt का कैसे करेंगे? ये देख लो, okay? Equivalent weight of salt is molar mass of salt upon charge furnished by salt. So this charge is either the positive charge or the negative charge, ठीक है? तो ये देख लो, Okay, equivalent weights are given over here. You can also calculate the equivalent weights of salts using the equivalent weight of cation added to the equivalent weight of anion. This is a little more tricky. So just take the molar mass of the entire salt, divide by the charge of either the positive side or negative side. Isko note down kar lo ek bari. Giving you 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay. Theek hai? Now this is the complicated example. Some people ask, sir, hydrated salt ka kaise kare when there is water of hydration. You've seen POP, yeah, plaster of Paris dekha hai. Toh usme kya hota hai? There is always some water associated with the salt itself. Now tell me, will the water part react? Will the water part react? Fatafat batao, jaldi batao, so gaye sare. Don't sleep, people, we are yet to do questions. Tell me. The water part will not react, yes? Janvi, I have done that discussion today and in yesterday's class. Please watch them once again. Okay. So this water part will not react, okay? So this guy, no reaction. Only this guy does the reaction, yeah? So do you agree that the charge for this particular salt will come only from Na2CO3 part? Yeah? So the net positive charge will be equal to how much? Net positive charge is equal to how much? Na2CO3, two positives. Yeah. Or let's say net negative charge is equal to two negative. So the valency factor is still equal to two. So how do you calculate the equivalent weight? You calculate the weight of this entire thing. 2 times sodium plus carbon plus 3 times oxygen plus 10 times water. Uska weight nikalo, divide it by 2. Okay, but because this water part will get dissolved in the solution, wo reaction mein part nahi lega. The reaction part will always be the ions. Yeah, okay, water is just turning into the solvent later on. Okay, so the solvent H2O does not ionize. Yeah, because it's a solvent, it will dissolve in water. तो वो रिएक्शन नहीं करेगा, वो सॉल्वेंट बन के बैठ जाएगा. सो ओनली द सॉल्ट कंट्रीब्यूट्स टू द चार्ज. सो मोलर मास इज इक्वल टू 286. सोडियम का लिया, कार्बोनेट का लिया एंड वाटर का भी लिया. यू हैव टू टेक द मास ऑफ वाटर एज वेल एंड देन डिवाइडेड बाय द चार्ज फर्निश्ड बाय द सॉल्ट, दैट इज 2. सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू 143 ग्राम्स पर इक्विवेलेंट. इसका भी एक बारी नोट ले लो. 5, 4, 3, 2 एंड 1. वेरी सिंपल. क्या? चलो अब ये क्वेश्चन करते हैं. नाउ पीपल विल डू सम इंटरेस्टिंग एडवांस्ड क्वेश्चंस. ओके, इफ यू फाइंड दीज क्वेश्चंस इजी, वेरी गुड जॉब. जे मेन्स विल बी लाइक अ पीस ऑफ केक फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू. ओके श्रीकांतन, थैंक्स मैन. चलो ये वाला करते हैं. इफ 0.5 मोल्स ऑफ BaCl2 इज मिक्सड विद 0.2 मोल्स ऑफ Na3PO4, the maximum number of moles of Ba3PO4 whole twice that can be formed is. Karo, thoda sa time deta hu, chat box mein batao fir. Thank you so much, Amar. Yes, Abhik, that is the way the equivalent concept is defined from scratch. Okay, usko define hi waisa kiya jata hai, dost. So if you have complications about how that came into picture, please watch the class that was aired on Tuesday at 5 PM. Okay. It's on the channel itself. Chalo, chalo, karo isko. Manmeet, you don't need the weights. Weight would chahiye nahi actually. Weight wagera chahiye nahi actually. Kya bol raha hai ye? Let me take the pen. This is saying that you've got to combine BaCl2 and Na3PO4. Okay, which gives you, okay, Ba3PO4 whole twice. And the hint that I'll give you, the hint that I'll give you is, all the barium comes from here and all the PO4 comes from here. This is the hint. Okay. I for inspiration? No. बेरियम यहाँ से आया, फॉस्फेट यहाँ से आया, तो कैसे करेंगे? बताओ 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 कैसे करेंगे? चलो आई विल सॉल्व इट फॉर यू नाउ, ठीक है, लेट्स कीप दिस इन माइंड. नाउ दिस इज 0.5 मोल्स ऑफ BaCl2. डू यू रियलाइज दैट वी हैव 0.5 मोल बेरियम अवेलेबल? दिस इज व्हाट्स अवेलेबल टू अस. यस, दिस इज द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ बेरियम दैट वी कैन हैव. सो आउट ऑफ दिस गाय, आउट ऑफ दिस बेरियम, हाउ मच Ba3PO4 होल ट्वाइस कैन वी मेक? Remember principle of atomic conservation. So this can give you a maximum of, okay, this can give you a maximum of 0.5 by 3 moles of the product. Yeah. So isse itna maximum mil sakta hai. Great. Now let us think about this guy, okay, 0.2 moles of Na3PO4. So do you realize that there is only 0.2 mole of PO4, 3 negative, agreed, that there is only 0.2 moles of PO4, 3 negative. You need twice of that पर मॉलिक्यूल. दो मोल चाहिए हर मॉलिक्यूल के लिए. सो 0.2 से कितना बन जाएगा ये? 0.1 बन जाएगा. यस, सो आई कैन गेट अ मैक्सिमम ऑफ 0.1 मोल ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट. 0.1 कैसे आया? 0.2 डिवाइडेड बाय द नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स रिक्वायर्ड, द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ PO4 रिक्वायर्ड पर मोल ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट. So this is equal to 0.1. So do you realize that this is the limiting reagent now? ठीक है प्रीतम चमका? This becomes the limiting reagent because this can give you only 0.1 mole of the product. This guy can give you 0.5 by 3 moles of product. Yeah. So यहां से limit हो रहा है product मेरा. This is the limiting reagent. Hence only 0.1 moles will be formed. Do you see how this technique makes our life much easier? You could have done it using stoichiometry. Pura reaction likho, then balance the entire reaction, then write the initial amount, then find out limiting reagent, then using limiting reagent. Too much chaos. Simply use principle of atomic conservation. See what you have, see what you can make. The one that stops you from the reaction is the limiting reagent. Very nice. ठीक है, बड़ा simple. Yeah. So this easily could be a JEE Mains question, a JEE Advanced question as well if they want to set a little easy paper. हो सकता है बड़े आराम से. Because normal people will spend 5 minutes on this. You will now spend only half a minute. Great. चलो next question. This is a JEE Main 2017 question, by the way. Okay, this is a JEE Main 2017 question. Let's read it out. Arey bhai, ek second, huh? Yeah. The most abundant elements by mass in the body of a human adult are oxygen, carbon, hydrogen, and nitrogen. The weight which a 75 kg person would gain if all the 1H atoms are replaced by 2H atoms is, okay? You have to calculate the weight that is gained, okay? Extra weight kitna ho gaya, wo calculate karna hai. 2017 JEE Mains ka question hai ye. Karo. Karo, 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 karo. Okay, Manmeet is saying C should be the answer. Let us see. Kratika is also saying the same. Two people have given me the same answer. Socho, socho, socho. In the body of the 75 kg person, how much hydrogen is there? 7.5 kg. Theek hai? Hydrogen, which is 1H atom. Okay, 1H in a body is equal to 10%, which is equal to 75 into 10%. This is 7.5 kilograms. Fine. Now All of this is converted to 2H. Protium ka deuterium bana diya. We've made protium into deuterium. What is the difference between protium and deuterium? This has double the mass. This guy has double the mass. So that 7.5 kilograms of hydrogen has essentially turned into 7.5 kilograms of hydrogen has essentially turned into 15 kilograms of deuterium now. 15 kilogram. So what is the gain in weight? Gain in weight is equal to weight final minus weight initial. This is equal to 15 minus 7.5. This is equal to 7.5 kilograms. Khatam. Okay, as simple as that. Do you realize you don't need to know the mole concept to solve this question? It's just mathematics. You just need to know that this is double the weight of the first one. This is a JEE Mains question. Okay, ye carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, aise hi de rakha hai, free mein. Okay, this is a JEE Main 2017 question. Maze ho gaye. Okay, so I'd like to make a point over here. JEE Main is an easy examination. You don't need to get scared about it. A lot of people, before they go into the examination, they give up. Sometimes they think, oh, there's too much to study. I'm a young person. Mere dimag mein nahi baithta ye sab, etc., etc. They just get underconfident and they give up. If you don't give up, if you go in the examination with confidence, the exam is pretty easy, alright? So, chill maar ke, confidence rakh ke, give the examination, you'll get it. Alright? It's just that your nervousness will make you do a mistake in this question. Otherwise, it's a simple question. Next one now. Very good question, in fact. From the very first class, but a very good question. Aray yaar, ye slide aage chal jaati hai. Haan, ye lo. How many moles of electrons weigh 1 kilogram? Okay. Ved, thank you so much, yaar. Alright, this is an old JEE Advanced question, in fact. I'm not kidding when I say that. It's an old JEE Advanced question. Okay. How many moles of electrons weigh 1 kilogram? Okay, yeah. S laga lo, electrons. Okay. How many moles of electrons weigh 1 kilogram? Asaan question hai, jyada mushkil nahi hai. Okay, very, very easy question. And just to give you a hint, okay, for those of you who are solving it, I'll give you a hint for this question. Think about it like this. Let's say there's a box of chocolates. Okay, masa ek box hai. It's got lots of chocolates in it. This has, let's say, 48 chocolates. Okay, if this guy has 48 chocolates, how many dozen chocolates are here? Kitne darjan chocolate hai isme? Yeah, absolutely. This is 4 dozen chocolates. How did you get the number 4? The number 4 comes from, okay, the given number upon the number for 1 dozen. So, 1 dozen kaise aaya? Total number divided by 1 dozen. How many moles of electrons? Total number of electrons divided by the number for 1 mole. Aage answer. Ho gaya khatam. This is where people do silly mistakes. They give just the total number of electrons sometimes. Okay, it's very simple. To karke dekhte hain usko. Ye chocolate hata deta hun yahan se main. Yeah, let's quickly solve that question. Alright, so how many moles of electrons by 1 kilogram? One electron is equal to 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kilograms. Yeah. So, 1 by 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 is equal to 1 kg of electrons. This many electrons are 1 kg, but how many moles is this? Okay. Moles will be equal to the total number divided by Avogadro's number. So, this will be equal to 1 by 9.1
into 6.022 into 10 to the power 31 minus 23.
Bas, aage answer. As simple as that. This is something that you have to remember. Okay, this is something that you should remember. We did it in the first chapter of atomic structure. Okay, this data was actually given. Okay, advanced wale log thode pyare hote hain. They give you data. They don't want to memorize. They don't want you to memorize a lot of things. So they will give you molecular masses. They will give you the mass of the electron, etc. ठीक है? तो बड़ा ही simple सा question था. The only thing is you have to divide it by the Avogadro's number. Otherwise, you would do a silly mistake. Great. JEE advanced question. Let's do this question now. This is a good one. This is the last question that we'll do in today's class. फटाफट से करते हैं. ये आपका homework रहेगा. Yeah, let's do this question. Last question, people. In the preparation of iron from hematite by the reaction with carbon, how much of 80% pure iron could be produced from 120 kilograms of 90% pure Fe2O3? Use POAC, but just be smart about one thing. Read the English carefully. Okay? Read the English carefully. Preetam, great man. Okay, Gautam Raja is saying it has to be 94.5 kilograms. Okay, let's see. Reema, since you have a test tomorrow, I can't take a lecture today. Great, but Harshal, man, great. So, Reema, Vedantu pe search karo, mil jayegi koi video chemical equilibrium ki. Chalo, last question. Okay. How much of 80% pure iron could be produced from 120 kilograms of 90% pure Fe2O3? And think about the English of this. Angrezi bahut zaruri hai yahan pe. Okay. Think about the English of this. So Aditya and Gautam Raja are saying that it has to be 94.5 kilograms. Anyone else? Karlo solve. I'll give you another minute. Fir main solve karta hun, fir class wrap up karta hai. Okay, Manu. Great. Hanji. Okay, futuristic DNA is also saying 94.5 kilograms. Waiting for a couple more answers and then I will solve it for you. For people who are watching this session as a replay and not as a live, you can forward a little bit, alright? Achha, Manmeet is saying, nahi, 65 hona chahiye. Okay. 65 to option hi nahi hai, Manmeet. Janvi is also saying 94 has to be the answer. Chalo, soch ke dekhte hai. Let us try to think about it. This is where the iron is coming from. Yes. So, all the iron that I have will get converted into iron later on. This is pretty simple. The only thing is they've confused you with percentages. Yes. Sochte hai. Initially, okay, initially I have 90% pure. Okay, what is that? Fe2O3. ठीक है. This is how much? 120 kg. So, pure Fe2O3 is how much? How much is the pure Fe2O3? जल्दी बताओ कितना है? 90% pure है उसमें से. 10% खराब है. Yes. So, 108. 12 into 9, 108 kilograms of Fe2O3 is pure. Okay, so what is the molecular weight of Fe2O3 now? Ab moles calculate karta na, we have to calculate the moles of Fe2O3 that we have. So moles of Fe2O3 kitna ho gaya dosto? Divided by molecular weight. What's the molecular weight? Pritam, us pe aayenge, fatafat se aayenge bas. What's the molecular weight? You guys have to tell me. You guys know. If you've learned from me, I don't know any molecular weight, assume. So you have to tell me what's the molecular weight. Iron is 56, oxygen is 16. Karo calculate. Jaldi. Nahi to question reh jayega. We have to finish the class. Okay, Pritam is saying 160. This is the number of moles of Fe2O3. So, moles of iron are equal to how much? आयरन कितने मोल है यहाँ पे, 108 अपॉन 160 इंटू टू, बिकॉज देर आर टू मोल्स ऑफ आयरन, ठीक है 160 अप्रोक्सीमेटली लगा लेते हैं, ठीक है. सो मोल्स ऑफ आयरन इज दिस मच. या नाउ मास ऑफ प्योर आयरन इज हाउ मच, मास ऑफ प्योर आयरन दैट वी ऑब्टेन. ओके, ये अभी तक प्योर आयरन मिल रहा है. मास ऑफ प्योर आयरन ऑब्टेन्ड विल बी इक्वल टू 108 इंटू टू इंटू 56 अपॉन 160. दिस इज द मास ऑफ प्योर आयरन प्रोड्यूस्ड. यस, ये आयरन प्योर है, इतना अपने को चमकता है. यस, yes, इतना सबको समझ आ गया. दिस इज द प्योर आयरन. नाउ व्हाट डज द स्टेटमेंट से, लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड हाउ मच ऑफ 80% प्योर आयरन कुड बी प्रोड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम दिस. फाइनली व्हाट यू विल गेट इज, ओके मैं ऊपर वाला मिटा रहा हूं अभी. ओके, फाइनली व्हाट वी गेट इज, डू यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू विल गेट वन ह्यूज ब्लॉक ऑफ आयरन. ये होगा आयरन का ब्लॉक. This block, this entire block is just 80% pure. Okay, in this block 80%, okay, 80% is iron and 20% is impurity. This final block ka 80% is this weight. Okay, got it? मंथन 11, 12 दोनों को पढ़ाता हूं दोस्त. ये चमका, आई थिंक देयर इज एन इंसेक्ट ट्रैप्ड समवेयर नियर माय आई. ओके, सो द फाइनल ब्लॉक का 80% इज दिस. तो मैं ये भी हटा देता हूं. अरे यार दिस बोर्ड इज सो वियर्ड. या सो 80% ऑफ द फाइनल थिंग 80/100 into x, let's assume the mass of the entire block is x, is equal to 108 into 2 into 56 upon 100. Now calculate what is x. अब x calculate कर लो. तो यहाँ से ये काट देते हैं अपन. अच्छा ये 160 है, sorry. So हो जाएगा अभी. How much does it come out to be? कितना आ गया, कितना आ गया? What's the final answer then? Remind the upcoming week, he is coming back. जल्दी करो दोस्तों, टाइम खत्म हो गया अपना. स्मार्ट गुरु प्लीज वॉच द रीप्ले. वी हैव टू फिनिश दिस क्लास मैन. ये क्या हो रहा है इसको? ओके, द बोर्ड इज ऑल्सो रिवोल्टिंग फॉर सम रीजन. वॉट इज गोइंग ऑन विद इट? ग्रेट. ऑल राइट पीपल, द बोर्ड हैज गिवन अप. वेल, अरविंद सुतार सर कम हियर प्लीज. वी हैड रीच द आंसर बट अगेन द बोर्ड हैज गिवन अप. ब्रो डिड यू डू समथिंग? आई डोंट नो, द बोर्ड इज नॉट वर्किंग फॉर सम रीजन. इसका कुछ फिगर आउट करते हैं भाई, क्या चल रहा है ये. ब्रो डिड यू do something with the remote or anything? Okay people, so the board has given up but we got that answer. 94 ke aas paas hi aayega. Chalo theek hai, whatever the case may be, I hope you got that answer and I'll take your leave. Arvind Sutar sir is here, he has to take a class, so we got to figure out how to fix this batch. So I hope you understood the entire chapter of the mole concept. If you haven't, please watch the classes from the beginning. I'll take your leave right now. If you want to learn general organic chemistry, please go on YouTube and search for Epic GOC, EPIC GOC, and you'll get my videos. Until then, I'll take your leave.
Must watch. That series is must watch, guys.
Thank you,
if
sir.
If you want to kill JEE, you should definitely go there and watch all of the videos.
Okay.
Right? Yes.
Yeah. And futuristic DNA paid courses ke liye, log into vedantu.com. Much more result oriented, and you'll get lots of material and test series, etc. etc. Chalo, bye bye, take care, good night. Abhi Arvind sir aayenge aapke paas.